All right, welcome back, YouTube, for another market analysis for the London session. Good to be back with you guys here, and we're going to be going over some levels here for S&P 500 and also gold. So let's go ahead and kick it off here. Let's take a look at this 10 tick chart here on S&P and see what we've been doing so far during this Asian session, kind of leading up into the actual London session. So we can see we were slightly sideways. Looks like we're starting to try to go back in trend. We do have this level sitting here at these 91.75. So waiting to see how this pulls back. One of two things that we can wait for here for an idea of a trade is if we pull back to hold the resistance here, one, two rotations, we could actually be looking for a rip lower into these 91.75s. Now, that would be our first opportunity to short. Now, if we don't see that, if we see a pullback here to the upside here and we look for a break back down, so it's going to be one try, two try, that's going to be our two try failure. It could look like that. It can also look something along the lines of it hits that level and then it angles up just a little bit, comes back, we get a two try failure there, higher lows. We'll look for that upside movement to the maybe right around these 20s. Well, no, that's maybe about 32.17, and then upside would be right around these 22s to about 27s. That's what we would be looking at. So that's our two opportunities. Now, once we get above this level of 13.75, we could stall for a bit. Now, if we don't see the rotations on top, if it collapses back underneath, then we could be looking to go right back down. But if we do see the rotations hold this support, then again, we're going to have that continuation. We should then have that slight hidden channel that moves us up there, and we'll be looking for that upside right around those 20 to 25s. So that's what we're going to be looking for on the S&P. We'll take a look right now on this 5 tick, what it actually looks like here. So this 5 tick that we have sitting here is, again, we're looking for this to pull back into these old threes, right? Right around these 32.03s is kind of where we want to see that resistance. If we can see that resistance on that pullback, then we're going to be looking for another continuation lower. So again, hit this level and get an opportunity to go lower, right? What do we have as far as technicals? We could see that we're slightly under. We got some bearish movement coming. VWAP is over, right? So we could actually get a really good opportunity to short this, right? Whether we're going to get back to these old threes, old fours, well, that depends on if we have enough momentum to push us back into that, or to at least pull us back into that. We could stall right here at these 3200s, but again, we want to see at least a couple rotations stall there, and then we'll get a continuation lower. That's going to be a good opportunity for us for that downside move. Again, if we don't get that, we're going to be looking for that to come right back above, give us that two try failure here on this 5 tick, and then we'll see some upside from there. So again, that's what we're going to be looking for on S&P 500. Let's also take a look. All right, so pulling up this 10 tick here on gold, we can see that we were in a slight range. You can see how it was forming here and also forming here. Market finally just shot up. That's kind of what we were looking at prior, and then the market came all the way back down, kind of held this level as resistance, and now we're back up. What do we think we're probably going to be doing is maybe moving back into a range. You can see we have a double top right at the top over here, and the market should be pulling back. Where do we think we're going to pull back? Right to the bottom of these 1808.6s. That's our target level right here. That's what we're going to be looking for on this downside. And then from there, we're going to be looking for some support for an upside move if we can get that, right? So expecting this to go back into a range, but if we break down through this, we'll be looking for some resistance again, sitting here at these 08s, and then looking for a downside move continuation. Now, if we can't hold the support at 08, well, if we can't hold the resistance, excuse me, at 08, then we'll look for that support again and then look for the continuation. So it could break down, a little bit, give us a little bit of a head fake. And that's what happens usually, is if we do go back into a range, a sideways movement, we're going to see sometimes it holds that level clearly, sometimes it breaks right through, gives us that head fake, and then we have an opportunity to continue this trade back to the upside. So that's what we're going to be looking for on gold. Let's take a look at a smaller chart here real quick. So we're right in the middle of that value area currently. So it probably wouldn't be the greatest of trading areas, but we do know it's probably going to want to pull back down into these 08s, right? So if you do want to trade here, I'd say I mean, you probably got to watch out for some rotations here, but I would say best opportunities to short that top, go long at this bottom. That's kind of what we're looking at. Could go into trend, but we'll see once we're below these 08s, then we can kind of see a trend movement down into the 04 and then below that. But we're going to be looking for those during the London session. If you guys are going to be in the room, it will be great to see you guys in there going through this with me like we usually do during the London session. But if not, thank you guys for all popping in here and watching this video. If you're not subscribed to the channel yet, please go ahead and subscribe. If you did like this video, please go ahead and give a thumbs up. I will be creating more content along with the psychology videos, performance psychology videos, more of that for you guys in these next coming weeks and getting back to our usual routine. But again, thank you guys for subscribing and also for the likes on these videos. You guys take care. Have a great night.